Merong petition ngayon to disqualify presidential candidate Marcos. At ito ay final ni dating spokesman ng Supreme Court, Theodore Te, in behalf of some civil liberties group. Basically, ang sinasabi nila ay merong conviction si Marcos because he was found guilty on July 27, 1995 of violation of Section 45 ng National Internal Revenue Code at saka Section 50 of the Internal Revenue Code where he was asked to pay a fine by the Regional Trial Court of Quezon City in the amount of 30,000. Section 12 of the Omnibus Election Code states that anyone who has been sentenced by final judgment for any offense with a penalty of more than 18 months for a crime or for a crime involving moral turpitude shall be disqualified to be a candidate and to hold office. So, ang tanong ngayon, ito bang conviction ng RTC 105 ng Quezon City at modified by the Court of Appeals a ground to disqualify presidential candidate Bongbong Marcos? Now, ang sabi sa Omnibus Election Code, 18 months or more sa ang sentensya to be disqualified. If you will look into the Court of Appeals decision, ang penalty na inimpose kay Marcos ay fine, hindi imprisonment. So, that will now say na that Section 12 will not apply to Bongbong Marcos. Ang tanong ngayon, yung namang moral turpitude, is it a ground to disqualify Bongbong Marcos? In a case in 2009, habang pending yung Court of Appeals decision involving Marcoses din, sabi ng Supreme Court, yung violation of the National Internal Revenue Code is not a crime involving moral turpitude. So actually, tapos na yung issue sa Supreme Court and for obvious reasons, nare-revive lang ngayon yan. No? But if the case of moral turpitude will disqualify a candidate, ano nga ba itong moral turpitude na yan? In Villaver versus Commission on Elections, ang sabi nila, ang definition ng moral turpitude based on Black's Law Dictionary, it is an act of baseness, vileness, depravity in the private duties which a man over his fellow men or in general does. It's contrary to law, contrary to morals. In other words, napaka ang ginawa mo ay napaka bastos, nang gugulang ka, nang iisa ka, and it is contrary to the senses of morality. So, first question, meron bang moral turpitude sa conviction ni Marcos? Ang sabi naman ng moral turpitude, dapat may intent to violate the law. Sinasadya mong i-violate ng law. But moral turpitude is not a crime if you do it because of an accident, because of a mistake, because of a misapprehension of the laws in good faith. So hindi yan mag-a-apply. So was Marcos charged with tax evasion? Hindi ba siya nagbabayad ng buwis for the past 4 years as alleged by the petitioners? You must remember that Marcos was then a government employee. I think he was either vice governor or governor. And during that time, ang tax niya was withheld pagkasweldo niya. No, parang private employee. Pag ikaw ay nagsweldo, bawas na yung taxes due to government. In other words, hindi naman siya nagta-tax evasion kasi yung tax bayad. Now, pangalawa, ano yung charges levied against him? Was it tax evasion? The answer is no. No? Section 45 ng National Internal Revenue Code is for failure to file income tax. Lahat tayo ay required to file an income tax return. Kahit zero income ka, dapat nagfa-file ka every year ng income tax return. So, itong failure to file an income tax return ang na-penalize ng 30,000 fine. Now, yung another charge niya, failure to fail deficiency income tax. In other words, na-audit siya. No? Na-audit siya, pero hindi niya binayaran yung diferensya between tax withheld and yung findings ng BIR. In other words, the cases filed against him are civil in nature, hindi criminal in nature. And for purposes of determining moral turpitude, kailangan kasuhan uli siya ng separate criminal offense or separate crime or separate civil offense for a violation of law involving moral turpitude. So, in other words, hindi automatic yung moral turpitude na sinasabi. So, right now, the cases filed before the COMELEC to disqualify, hindi rin naman COMELEC ang magdi-disqualify sa kanya. Ang final arbiter dyan ay yung Supreme Court na siya ay disqualified on the ground of conviction because of a civil liability. And like I said, in 2009, in the case of People versus Ferdinand Marcos and Imelda Marcos, sabi na ng Supreme Court that a violation of the National Internal Revenue Code is not a crime involving moral turpitude.